Next, I'd like to introduce Jay Palmer. And Jay has been working to bring light to illegal schemes used by outsourcing, the outsourcing type companies that Dina just mentioned, that unlawfully employ H-1B visa workers. In 2010, Jay filed a whistleblower complaint that led to an investigation. And for the past 4 years, he has been working with Department of Homeland Security, State Department, the IRS, to train and educate government agents on how illegal operations work from within this outsourcing industry. So it's a real pleasure to have you here today, Jay, and give a round for Jay Palmer.
Good morning, everybody. I want to thank Kevin for having me. I want to thank Kevin for having me here today. And, you know, my mom would be pleased. She always wanted me to be a preacher, so standing behind a pulpit might make her day. What I want to talk about today is everyone knows the H-1B visas and the fraud and the intent. But first of all, I want to thank President Trump, Stephen Miller, AG Sessions, and Gene Hamilton, who are working diligently to put a stop to this. And I support these people 100%, and I just give them time. They're on the right road with the executive order. Stephen Miller knows what he's talking about. AG Sessions knows what he's talking about, and we will stop this abuse. What I want to talk about today is a little bit off the norm of the H-1B visa. I want to talk about not only are American workers being put out of work, I want to talk about the education of the current H-1B workers. I know. I've managed and worked with H-1B workers for many years. There are some very intelligent ones, but I would say 1 out of 100. The rest had problems speaking English, and they could not perform the job. End of story. What I'm learning now, probably over the last year, is mind-boggling. I have example after example of fake resumes, fake credentials, everything from educational. I have evidence and videos of one person's resume and another person Skyping to do the interview, which is just extremely alarming to me. Not only is the system being broken, but the American worker is being put out of work, and also the Indian worker is being abused horribly. I've been providing information on this program that was created to help create American jobs, but it's doing the opposite, exactly the opposite. H-1B workers, while Americans are being laid off, are being bought and sold. It's legalized human trafficking. I can tell you that right now. These workers will leave one mom-and-pop staffing company and sold to another for between $20,000 and $25,000 for their H-1B. Then they have to pay back the company that bought them. They leave these other companies in hope that they're going to make more than the prevailing wage. That's the carrot that's dangled in front of them. In actuality, they're living 8 to 10 to a guest house, and they're having to look for their own jobs. They're having to pay their own visas. I have a list of companies right now, which are smaller companies, that if you're in India and you want an H-1B, you have to pay this company $10,000 just to put your name into the lottery. If you are selected in the lottery, for them to sponsor your H-1B, you have to pay them another $15,000 to $20,000 for them to sponsor it. Then you get to the United States, supposedly having to work, and they faked the resume and the educational credentials. Then you get over here, and then somebody like Dina has to train you to do your job. What is wrong with this? What is wrong with this picture? What is wrong with our country when this happens? This has been going on for years and years and years. This is not about the advancement of our country or our educational system. It takes three steps back. I talk to a lot of college kids, high school kids that want to go into technology. They don't. They won't go into it because they won't be able to get a job. I own a small consulting company right now, and literally I get 7 or 8 emails or phone calls a week from American workers looking for jobs, telling me, do you have anything for me? And then from Indian workers telling me, I'm making, after everybody gets their piece of the pie, I'm getting $15 an hour, and I have no health insurance. And we're putting Americans out of work for this. And you know, I want to know why people do this. And if you've ever been to India, which I have, you'll know why. They'll work for $15 an hour. You know, we're supposed to be a land of opportunity, but we're displacing our own American workers right now. This is not what the program was created for. You know, as Senator Grassley said, you know, this needs to be reformed, and it needs to be reformed without loopholes. There's so much gray in this area right now. So much gray. When I was privileged to do a news show not long ago, I talked to some of the workers that had been displaced. One of them worked for the Port Authority of New York and New Jersey and was displaced by an H-1B worker for a state agency. It's mind-boggling how this continues to happen. You know, a lot of people call me a hypocrite because I fight for the American worker, but also from a human rights standpoint, I fight for the American worker, but I'm also torn apart by the abuse that somebody comes to the United States and how they're treated. So, you know, this database, what I see in this database is, even in Montgomery, Alabama, where I live, I had Kevin pull some stats for me about a company I'm not going to mention. And there were a lot of H-1B workers there in Montgomery, Alabama, for this insurance company. And I'm sitting here thinking, our veterans are coming back. Montgomery, if no one knows, Maxwell Air Force Base and Gunner Air Force Base is the hub for IT technology for the United States Air Force. We have veteran after veteran coming back with technology backgrounds. Just wonderful, you know, Java, J2AA Swing, you know, everything. And these companies are hiring H-1B workers for money. That's it. There's no other reason. There's no other reason. And what we need to do is to continue to fight to do what's right. So, you know, today I'm privileged to be here. And I'm privileged that this database, for me to be a part of being here. And, you know, lastly, support this man. Support the American worker. Now, we're not against companies making money. We're against companies, you know, having an ethical backbone and doing it the right way and not laying off people like Dina. I don't know the exact numbers, but I'm going to try to quote Dr. Ron Hira, who I respect more than he's a friend. The average American, the average H-1B worker makes 40%, I believe is the right number, of what an American worker would work. Now tell me how that's creating American jobs. I thank you for your time.